Hey guys, what's going on? It's Don here from Novaspirit Tech, and today we're going to be installing Kali Linux on our Raspberry Pi 3B+. So let's get started. Now, if you guys tried to install Kali Linux with the official image to our Raspberry Pi B+, you're going to notice that there are going to be issues booting up. That's because the official image does not have the latest update or the firmware for the B+ model. Now, it's April 2018, so it might have been updated by the time you... I don't know. So, anyway... There are two ways to fix that. One, you could actually download the firmware from Raspberry Pi's GitHub and then load it into SD card and you could boot it from there. Two, you could actually load in a separate image. Now, this guy actually created this image, I think, dedicated for the Raspberry Pi. It's called Sticky Fingers or Reason, or I'll leave a link in the description below so you know what I'm talking about. Now, this image itself is, like I said, made for the Raspberry Pi. It's also got the touchscreen drivers and also the nexmon monitoring mode for the Wi-Fi drivers, which means the Raspberry Pi 3, yeah, can go into monitoring mode. This image also supports the Raspberry Pi 0, W, 2, 3, and then like I said, the 3B plus that we're going to be testing right now. So what we're going to be more geared towards in this video is installing that image and setting it up properly. What I mean by properly is we're going to be changing out the root password, we're going to make SSH boot, also change the SSH key out, and also auto login, and maybe test out the Bluetooth, because I know Bluetooth works with this version. So yeah, let's get started with that. First thing you want to do is go to the link in the description and download the sticky finger image. It should be all the way on the bottom of the site. Once you're done downloading that, use Etcher to load the image into the SD card. Then take the SD card and put it into your Raspberry Pi. Now this is where all the fun happens. All right, so when you first log in, you're going to notice root is your username, and the password is Tor, which is root backwards. Remember, we gotta change that because people scan for that. So the first thing you wanna do is, let me see if I can make this font much bigger because, what is it, Control Plus? Yeah, zoom in, Control Plus. There you go, okay. So we're gonna do password, and we're gonna change our password. There we go. Password successfully changed using the password passwd. All right, so the next thing we want to do is actually change our SSH key. Now, every one of these images have the same key, so people could potentially break into these devices pretty easily. So what you want to do here is dpkg-reconfigure. I use tab to autocomplete, so that's why it looks like I'm typing really fast. Open SSH server. Give it a second, no error message, that means good. All right, now, so what we want to do here is set it up so our SSH will boot with our system, because right now you can't even log in through SSH, and in all Kali Linux images is like this. And you can actually take these steps to your Kali, you know, desktop installation if you want. Now, we're going to do update -rc.d-fssh remove. Okay, if I know how to spell it. -fssh remove. Okay, there you go. update-rc-dfssh defaults. You could ultimately just press the up arrow and change last key. All right, now what we want to do is restart the service. So we're going to do service ssh restart. And then we're going to now enable the boot up of our SSH. So we're going to do update rc.d-f SSH enable 3, 4, and 5, which is those are run levels. Run level 3, run level 4, and run level 5 will have SSH enabled. Now, it doesn't work yet. I mean, you have to physically be able to log into the machine, you know, through that prompt earlier, before SSH will turn on. So what we gotta do is make it so it auto logs in. Reason actually has a little small script that you could just run, and it's one click and it'll do everything for you. So we're gonna be running that script instead. What you need to do is slash usr, which is user, local, source, re4, and I'm just gonna hit tab to autocomplete the keys, because you see how it says 4.9, it's the kernel version and everything. Now here we're going to do reason re4so, and then I'm going to hit tab and let it autocomplete. And you see how it says reason-pi-tft-setup. We're going to put a space -a for auto login and the user account root. Now, why I chose this to do last is because it's going to reboot your system. So over here, we're just going to hit yes and reboot. Now it should automatically boot into the system, and there shouldn't be any prompt anymore. All right, you see how it booted up and it didn't ask me for any prompt. So next thing we're going to test out is the Bluetooth. Because of this image, it's got Bluetooth loaded in with all the drivers and everything. We could test that out by running our little utility. Let's make that bigger. And we're going to use Bluetooth CTL. And you see how it registered the device and it boots up. It didn't kick back any error messages. Let's do scan on. And now it can scan for devices. I bet you I have a lot of devices in here. And let's do a default agent. So we can make sure it defaults. Here we have it. Bluetooth does work. I'm going to exit this. Clear this screen. The next thing we're going to do is I really wanted to show you guys, which is the monitoring mode. Monitoring mode is huge, especially if you're going to do some Wi-Fi hacking and or packet sniffing and stuff like that. So first thing you need to do is enable the Wi-Fi monitoring mode device. So I would do IW physical 0 interface add mon 0 type monitor. All this will actually be on my blog, which is linked below, so you could just copy and paste the commands. But yeah, once I hit enter, if it didn't get an error message, you're good. Next thing is to test out the monitoring mode itself. So we're going to do if config mon 0 up. Now it should be in monitoring mode, and let's do an if config, and you see the monitoring is up. Now to test it out, we're going to do aero dump, and we'll just put it to mon 0. There we have it, guys. It's sniffing, it's monitoring, it's capturing packets. So yeah, I'm not going to leave this on for that long, but yeah, that is it. It's capturing all the traffic that we need in monitoring mode. So the only thing about this, the range on the Raspberry Pi is very limited. Now, normally in where I am right now, I should be able to even see my neighbor's Wi-Fi. I should see a couple of neighbors' Wi-Fi, but the range on the Raspberry Pi is not that great. So you might want to still stick on another USB, you know, Wi-Fi adapter. But other than that, monitoring mode is working, which is great. All right, guys, so that's it for me. If you guys enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. If you guys got any questions about it, hit it in the comments below. I did start a Discord channel, which is now fully configured, and also a forum, which I am still working on, but it's got a bunch of users right now. Go check them out. I'll have links in the description below. If you guys are new to this channel, consider subscribing and also hitting that bell notification icon so you know when the next video is going to be out. And as I say in my nerd cave, hack till it hurts.